As of 1 May 2017, there were over 6,000 cooked food stalls in the hawker centres owned by the government. About 97% of them were occupied. This is the consistent average occupancy rate for the past 5 years. The average successful tender bid for our cooked food stalls over the last 3 years is $1,370 per month. The lowest bid was $1, while the highest bid was $4,888. This excludes a recent exceptional case where there was a successful bid of $10,000 for a stall at the People's Park Hawker Center, but the bidder terminated the tenancy even before he started operations. At my ministry's Committee of Supply debate last year, I shared with the member, Mr. Gan Thiam Poh, the background of our termination in 1990 of our previous policy of allocating available vacant hawker stalls to those in financial hardship. I explained at the time that the take-up rate had consistently been very low, and moreover, most of the applicants had rejected our offered stalls and preferred to wait for a vacancy in the more popular hawker centres. There are therefore no grounds to reinstate this policy, nor allocate hawker stalls at market rents to only those who are retrenched or require financial assistance. Like any other self-employed person, a hawker can sustain his business successfully if he is disciplined and has the required skills, and not simply because he is in need of a job. Those who are genuinely interested in the hawker trade are welcome to bid for any of the vacant stalls which the National Environment Agency puts out for tender every month. Those who are in need of financial and other types of assistance, including employment assistance, they may wish to seek the assistance of the Ministry of Social and Family Development or the Workforce Singapore, respectively.
Mr. Gan Thiam Poh.
Yes, Madam, thank you, Assessment, for the reply. I hear you, but will Ministry consider working with any specific organization or institutions to actually provide training or even looking at how to assist those who are retrenched or those who are receiving financial assistance who wish to become hawker? Thank you.
Indeed, we do have programs that we have recently implemented to help those who are interested to join the hawker trade to do so, including, of course, those who may have been retrenched and are looking to join the hawker trade, perhaps as a second pathway. So, through the recommendations of the Hawker Centre 3.0 Committee, we have actually launched a hawker fair series where aspiring hawkers can actually learn tips and culinary skills from veteran hawkers. We have started this series and it has been overwhelmingly subscribed. We are also going to start a course, a hawkerpreneur course with IT College West, where they will teach these aspiring hawkers simple skills on how to run a hawker stall, pricing, etc., as well as even how to apply and bid for a hawker stall, so that they will be able to bid, you know, at a realistic price at something, at a rent that their business can sustain. In addition to that, at the end of the year, we are looking at introducing some incubator stalls at some of our hawker centres for aspiring hawkers who qualify. There will be certain criteria they'll have to qualify, and they can actually try out, you know, their skills and their acumen at these incubator stalls before they actually take the plunge and join the hawker trade. In addition, I think that some of the other policies we have implemented in recent years, for instance, removing the reserve rent, as well as, of course, controlling assignment and subletting, actually also helps to lower the entry barrier for aspiring hawkers so that, you know, that you discourage the tendency to bid at very unrealistic prices.